A very pleasant morning, dear students. Happy to see you again. And in the previous class, we have seen how Lamu and Natalia had got a great and a very severe argument over Oxen Meadows, isn't it? And we have seen that Lamu was saying that he had got the documents of Oxen Meadows, but Natalia says that she doesn't stand on unfairness because she is the one who could stand on the principles. Okay, in the previous class we had a discussion on this topic, the conversation between Lamu and Natalia. Once again I would like to remind you, I'll show you the documents, Natalia Stepnova. Natalia says, no, you are simply joking, making fun of me. What a surprise. We have had the land for nearly 300 years. How long did Natalia's family had this property in their hand? At about 300 years. And then we are suddenly told that it isn't ours. Ivan Vasilevich, I can hardly believe my own ears. These meadows aren't worth much to me. They only come to 5 deciems and are worth perhaps 300 rubles. When we convert this 5 deciems into rubles, they come nearly 300 rubles, but I can't stand unfairness. Whatever be the value of that land, Oxen Meadows, I won't mind, but I always stand on principles that too I don't like the unfairness. Because all of a sudden, after 300 years later, I could hear that the land doesn't belong to hers, isn't it? So that's why she says that she can't believe her ears. Lamu, hear me out, I implore you, means I beg you. Please underline the word implore, means to ask or beg earnestly. And this is my earnest request to you, and I beg you, the peasants of your father's grandfather, as I have already had the honor of explaining to you. You know, the peasants of your father's grandfather, as I have already had the honor of explaining to you, used to bake bricks for my aunt's grandmother, and now my aunt's grandmother wishing to make them a pleasant. Now my grandmother would like to make peace talks between us. She wants to make a peace talks. That is also one of the reasons of making an arrival to Natalia's house, isn't it? Natalia says, I can't make head or tail of all this about aunts and grandfathers and grandmothers. The meadows are ours, that's all, she says. She puts an end to this discussion and says that, I don't know what is head and tails. Please underline the word here. We can come across too many idiomatic expressions. Head or tail means, what is first and what is next? Who is first and who is next? Or who is last? And what is what? I don't know. That means she doesn't know what's the beginning and what's the end. She wants to make a nice decision at the end of their discussion. And Natalia is not at all agreeing with the argument of Lamu. Lamu says, it's mine. Natalia, no, it's ours. You can go on proving it for 2 days on end. You can go and put on 15 dresses jackets, but I tell you they are ours. What does it mean by 15 dress jackets? This is also one of the idioms. Means how many times you just go on with this argument, I never come on your way. Whatever I said is the last, and whatever I said, that's the final. Okay, I don't want to listen. I'm not at all interested to listen to your talk, she says. Please underline the word, the phrase 15 dress jackets. But I tell you they are ours. I don't want anything of yours, and I don't want to give anything of mine. So that, see, once it belongs to me, I don't like to share with anybody else. Surely this property doesn't come into your hands. I won't let this property come into your hand. Lamu, Natalia Stepnova, I don't want the meadows, but I'm acting on principle. What did he say? No, I don't want it. It's not a great valuable thing to me. It's not a big worth to me. Of course, that land is ours, but still I stand on principle, acting on principle. If you like, I'll make you a present of them. See, once you get tied with me, once we get knot, okay, once we both will become couples, okay, definitely this land, Oxen Meadows, I'll just gift it to you. I'll just present it to you. He says, Natalia, I can make you a present of them myself because they are mine. Your behavior, Ivan Vasilievich, is strange to say the least. Up to this, we have always thought of you as a good neighbor or a friend. See, I can't believe this. All these days, we just thought that me and my father thought that you are such a nice neighbor of ours. Who are you to give it that Oxen Meadows as a present? If I like your behavior, I would give it to you. Not you can give it to me. Because once it belongs to you, only you can say this. But that property belongs to me. How can my property can be given to me as a present? She says. Okay. And I can make you a present of them myself because they are mine. Your behavior, Ivan Vasilievich, is strange. Okay, I never thought that you would come out like this. You are such a strange and weird person. And to say that you are a least one. Okay, all these days I thought that you are a very good neighbor as well as a friend. Last year we lent you our threshing machine. What did they do? Last year they have given their threshing machine, although on that account we had to put off our own threshing till November. So we just postponed the threshing work to till November. They couldn't do it. Okay, till November they kept it in pending. But they had given, he had got the threshing machine from Natalia, okay, by keeping their work on pending. So, but you behave to us as if we were gypsies. Okay, how you are behaving with us? As if we were gypsies. I told you who are gypsies also. Okay, giving me my own land. Usually gypsies are the people, those who have no proper, okay, standard or stable living. They used to move from one place to another. Usually gypsies can be singers, magicians and musicians. And some people can also do some circus work. Okay, the people, those are doing some treacherous works, okay, walking on the thread or on the string. All these people come under the category of gypsies. I told you when I was teaching. Till here we have completed, I think so. No, really, that's not at all a neighborly. In my opinion, it's even impudent. It's not at all nice. It is disrespectful, impudent. Please underline the word impudent if you want to know. And in my opinion, it's all even impudent if you want to know. If you just wanted to know what kind of behavior that you are showing towards us or you are treating, okay? And she says that Lamo and Lamo's family is treating the family of Chubakov and Natalia as gypsies, she says. And she also added one more thing. In her opinion, it is disrespectful. It means Natalia's family was not at all given any respect by Lamo. Then you make out that I'm a land grabber, madam. Never in my life have I grabbed anybody else's land, and I shan't allow anybody to accuse me of having done so. See, he says that, Natalia, I'm so sorry to hear this. I'm not a land grabber. I haven't come here to grab your land. Suppose if I were a land grabber, I would have come here to talk only on Oxen Meadows. I never would come to you in order to ask your hand for marriage. Okay? So, and he was very much, I think he's disheartened after listening to Natalia, because Natalia was hating Lamo and she has no good opinion over Lamo anymore. And she says that he was also just defending himself, saying that I never even get involved in any such matters. I was not being accused. Nobody accused him of having done so. He was not being accused in any of that kind of case. Okay, this is the first time he had differences with the family of Natalia. And steps to the Carif, drinking cup, and drinks more water, Oxen Meadows or mine. And still Lamo says that after drinking water, he says that he has taken kefir. Actually, it's not kefir, Carif. Carafe is nothing but a drinking cup in which he poured water and drank more quantity of water, and he still says that Oxen Meadows. He was still singing the same song. Singing the same song means expressing the same kind of expression. What is that? That land is mine, that land is mine, and Oxen Meadows is mine. Then Natalia, it's not true, they are ours. Lamu says it's mine. Okay, let us come to page number 149. Natalia says, it's not true. I'll prove it. I'll send my mowers out to the meadows this very day. Today itself, this very day, I'll be sending my people mowers. Means the people, those who are mowing the grass mowers. Do you know who are mowers? The people, one who mows. Okay, cutting of the grass. It's not true. Even if you want me to prove it, I'll just send my mowers to to the Oxen Meadows. Lamo, what? Natalia says, my mowers will be there this very day. And Lamo, I'll give it to them in the neck. What did he say? If you send your mowers to my land, Oxen Meadows, definitely I'll kill them. Okay? I give them on their neck. In the sense, I'll cut their neck or I cause hurt to them. Natalia, you dare, how dare you to speak by coming to our place. Lamo clutches at his heart. Oxen Meadows are mine. You understand mine. And Lamo kept on saying that Oxen Meadows belongs to him only. Natalia, please don't shout. You can shout yourself hoarse in your own house, but here I must ask you to restrain yourself. You cannot shout at my very place. You go home and shout to your heart's wish. But you are not supposed to. If you are not supposed to shout at my home, you try to restrain yourself, control yourself, she says. Lamo, if it wasn't, madam, for this awful, excruciating palpitation, if my whole inside was not upset, I would talk to you in a different way, and he else, Oxen Meadows are mine. So Lamo was losing his temper. Once we lose our temper, what happens? A great harm. The great harm would come to us, would happen. So the same thing. And Lamo's health is slowly getting worse. Okay, worse to worst. And he started saying that, suppose if I get any health issue like palpitations. What does it mean by palpitation? Means the heartbeat of a person will be increasing. Okay? The heartbeat of a person would be increasing. It's a kind of medical issue. It's a medical problem. Suppose if he kept on yelling and shouting, definitely he loses his control and he would be getting palpitations. And he kept on saying that Oxen Meadows are mine, and Natalia says ours, mine, ours, mine. They were arguing. Now enters Chabakar. Who was Chabakar? Father of Natalia Stepnova, isn't it? And she says, Chabakar, what's the matter? What are you shouting for? So you have come on a different purpose. After you have come to us, and your way of behavior is not up to the mark. What's the problem? Why are you shouting? He asked Natalia. Papa, please tell this gentleman who owns Oxen Meadows, we or he. Are you just tell me, because you are the elderly person, you know the history behind, and you please tell, and who's this Oxen Meadows belong to? Is it ours or his? Then Chabakar, to Lamo, darling, meadows are ours. How he was talking? How his daughter is talking to him, and how he started his talk. Darling, he says, Chabakar calls this man as darling, those Oxen Meadows are arts than Labo. But please step notch. How can they be yours? Do be a reasonable man. My aunt's grandmother gave this meadows for the temporary and free use of your grandfather's peasants. The peasants used the land for 40 years and got accustomed to it as if it was their own when it happened that. Lamo was very patiently explaining everything. My aunt's grandmother gave this meadows for the temporary use, free of charge. Okay? And the grandfather was given this land to, grandmother gave this land to peasants of your grandfather, and these peasants started using, they accustomed to use this land for years. How long they had used it? They had used nearly 40 years. And when they used this land for 40 years, the remaining period they just got used to that land and they hadn't given it back to. It means this land is taken on lease maybe. Free of cost, he says. We don't know whether Lamo's argument is correct or Chabakar's. Then Chabakar started speaking. Excuse me, my precious. First he said darling. Now he says precious. Okay, precious. Actually, what is the right way of pronouncing the word P-R-E-C-I-M-O-E-S? Precious. Okay, precious. Excuse me, my precious. You forget just this, that the peasant did not pay your grandmother and all that. You forget this, that the peasant did not pay your grandmother and all that, because the meadows were in dispute. We didn't pay. Actually, my grandfather's peasants didn't pay anything to your grandmother. Why? You know, this land is in dispute. When the land is got in dispute, actually no charge can be put on that. You cannot charge anything. And we are also not ready to pay you anything. You owed the land and we have taken it. I mean, my grandfather's peasants have taken it. And we need not to pay you anything because this land is in dispute. And so on. And now everybody knows that they are ours. But everybody, those who are living here since many years, they all know it. Maybe this generation may not know. But the previous generations and their great grandfathers and grandmothers and their children, they all know the history about this Oxen Meadows. Since very long, these Oxen Meadows are under our own control. So how can we give this land to you? That's the difference of opinion on giving out this Oxen Meadows to him. So it means that you haven't seen the plan. Maybe the plan you hadn't looked into. Once you go home, look into the document properly and find out what were the problems or what were the points that are written in the document. Lamo, I'll prove to you that they are mine. Definitely, I'll prove that land, Oxen Meadows belongs to our family. Okay? Chabakar says, you won't prove it, my darling. Lamo says, I shall prove it. Then Chabakar says, dear one, why L like that? You need not to L at us. You won't prove anything just by yelling. I don't want anything of yours. You don't intend to give up what I have. What should I? And you know, my beloved, that if you propose to go on argument about it, I'd much sooner give up the meadows to the peasants than to you. That Chabakar says, suppose if there comes a point of giving out this land to you, definitely this land I would be giving it to the peasants, those who are very, 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 very close with us. We get familiar with them. So I just wanted to give this land to him because you are yelling much upon us. What's the use of yelling at us? By yelling, you would be getting sick. Okay? Don't get sick and don't get angry with us. Suppose you are not giving up any land to us. And actually, if there is such case, if there is a point of giving out this land, definitely this land would be given it to whom? To the peasants. Understand? And the remaining part of this lesson will be continued later. Why I just carried little bit back, you know, most of you are not at all paying attention in reading the text. Whenever I just wanted to start something, okay, you will be having a problem because you never turn back the pages and look whatever we have finished. This is my sincere request to everybody. Please go through the lesson carefully and try to get the facts, because finding the facts from the story is very important to understand the lesson. This is such a lengthy lesson. We still got some 2 to 3 pages. Will be continued in the next class. Maybe my next online class would be going on with this lesson only. Okay, after finishing of hand drawing.